I've had many experiences with orcas off the south coast of Iceland. And there you got to see them in their natural environment. You got to see them majestic in every way. They're wide-ranging predators, traveling 100 miles a day and diving as much as 300 feet to forage. And they live in tightly knit family groups, often not leaving their birth family the whole lives. And in many of these families, the moms call all the shots.
We're talking about a level of emotional bonding that is beyond the par of what we experience as humans. Feelings and emotions come into play in orca and cetacean psychology in a very intense and very fundamental way. They have culture, they have dialects, they have interesting communication systems and a big brain. They're right up there with us. When you look at the orca brain through an MRI image, the neocortex, the thinking part of the brain, the gray matter, is actually more convoluted than that of the human brain. For a brain like that, there is nothing to do in a concrete tank.
There are actually 3,000 whales and dolphins in captivity around the world. There are 57 orca, more than 300 beluga, and they live in very small tanks, often not any deeper than the whales are long.
A concrete tank is like an auditory hall of mirrors. At first, they're going to get back a lot of echoes, and eventually, they're going to realize there's nothing to echolocate on. And at that point, they simply shut down.
And in captivity, they live in artificial families. Mothers and calves are separated based solely on commercial interest. Captive whales rarely live more than 20 years. Fewer than 50% lived more than 4 years after capture. The captive industry makes the point that they're providing education about orcas to all of their audiences. I think it's anti-educational. It teaches kids that we as humans should dominate them, as opposed to anything about what they are as animals, what their culture is.
The reason China and other countries are capturing orcas and other cetaceans and putting them in concrete tanks is because of the success of marine parks in this country.
One could lose hope. One could say there are more and more animals being captured and the numbers we have today will be nothing compared to what could happen in the future. But we have to put our hope in children to stand up and say no, and we'll demand of their parents, no matter where they live on the planet, that we treat these animals with understanding and care and keep them in the wild. As the public ethic around keeping whales and dolphins in captivity changes, people are demanding that the shows stop and that the animals have an opportunity to live in more natural environments. Most of the animals today in captivity were born in captivity. So releasing them would be in many ways tragic because they do not have the skills to survive in the wild. The best solution is to build natural seaside sanctuaries where captive whales and dolphins can live in an environment as close to their natural habitat as we can provide. They'll have a sandy bottom with critters, fish, and crabs with whom to interact. They'll have birds on the surface to chase, and they will have space more than 300 times more than the largest performance tank in captivity.
The captivity industry is looking at us. The public has the power to end this suffering.
Sanctuaries have been built for elephants, for gorillas, and big cats.
And now is the time to create sanctuaries for whales and dolphins.
There is another way. Here it is.
好欢迎大家今日出席香港海豚保育学会主办嘅《墙外的鲸豚》嘅放映同埋座谈会啦。系啦，咁今日呢个座谈会主要嘅主题咧，就系分享关于呢个圈养鲸豚同埋嘅问题啦，同埋我哋其实咧都已经系提议咗好耐一个叫做海滨庇护所嘅一个工作啦，就是、希望俾一啲喺圈养环境入边生活紧嘅鲸豚咧。是可以退休去一个好一点的环境生活的。个短片就看完了，非常精彩，大家看到很多很漂亮的一些散鲸画面，不同鲸豚的画面，还有里面都讨论了很多究竟圈养海豚或者圈养散鲸里面主要讲有什么问题呢，对动物造成有些什么的伤害呢。里面其实都很关、香港事的，就是即係佢提及到中國或者亞洲地區嗰個圈養產業其實發展得好快啦，亦都令到嗰啲好多鯨豚可能要喺野外被捉翻嚟啊，越嚟越多嘅鯨豚可能喺圈養入邊繁殖啊，咁樣亦都係延長咗佢哋同都同我哋係息息相關嘅。咁我哋見到 Charles 已經入咗嚟啦，咁首先非常歡迎佢啦，啱啱由電影入邊再跳出我哋現實生活同我哋傾偈咁樣。咁我首先簡單咁介紹一下 Charles 先啦。Charles 其實佢個經驗係非常之犀利，非常之豐富，即係聽完之後大家都會哇，即係哇一聲咁樣。咁 Charles 其實由2017年開始咧，就出任咗呢個 Whale Sanctuary Project 嘅執行董事啦。咁佢加入咗呢個會之前咧，就曾經擔任過兩間環境科技公司嘅行政總裁啦，包括就係 Florida 嘅一間叫 Ecosphere Technologies 嘅公司啦，同埋另一間。Aquantis 就喺 Santa Barbara 嘅，咁 Charles 喺1993年咧至到2003年咧就擔任咗一個NGO 嘅副會長啦，兩個 NGO 嘅副會長啦。咁呢兩個NGO 咧，其實佢主要都係透過舉辦啲活動同埋製作短片啊、紀錄片咁樣咧，去宣揚翻海洋同埋環境保育嘅資訊咁樣嘅。而在這段時間 Charles 也都是參與了殺人鯨或者虎鯨 Keiko 放歸冰島的這個計劃。這個這麼出名的放歸 Keiko 的計劃，其實就是電影，如果大家有看過叫 Free Willy 的一個真實的版本來的。這個電影出了之後，也都改變了很多人對圈養鯨豚的看法。Charles 呢對環境工作也都是、就是、投入了很多精神和時間。咁佢亦都曾經咧係被美國嘅白宮同埋洛杉磯嘅市政府咧表揚佢對環境工作嘅貢獻嘅，咁就係非常之厲害嘅一個鯨豚福利嘅爭取嘅保育人士啦，亦都係環境保護嘅工作者，一個好資深嘅前輩嚟嘅。係啦，咁或者我哋開始進入公眾環節之前，簡單跟 Charles 傾下偈，等佢熱下身，即係投入我哋今日嘅討論環節先。咁第一條問題想問 Charles 嘅，就係、其實頭先條片入邊咧有提及過，其實 Whale Sanctuary Project 喺加拿大嘅 Nova Scotia 已經係開展緊一個揾咗一個選址喺 Nova Scotia 啦，亦都係開始緊點樣去準。去準備嗰個海濱庇護所，話緊點樣擺一啲白鯨入去咁樣，可唔可以同我哋分享一多少少而家嗰個海濱庇護所嘅進度係去到邊度咧？咁我知道 Charles 係準備咗一啲slides 去話俾我哋知，而家究竟個海濱庇護所嘅進度係點樣嘅。
And so Tyson, just before we start with the slides, I want to thank you and thank all of the people with the Hong Kong Conservation, Dolphin Conservation Society for inviting me to join you.
Thank you so much, Charles.
Okay, so with the first slide, this is really just to show people where Nova Scotia is. And it's actually on the right side of the screen as you're looking at it, between Canada and the United States.
咁阿 Charles 咧開頭就好客氣咁樣去多謝咗我哋邀請佢嚟先啦。咁佢呢個圖咧，其實就係 show 俾我哋睇咧，究竟 Nova Scotia 嘅位置喺邊度嘅。咁佢啱啱就講咧，其實 Nova Scotia 就喺呢個地圖嘅右手邊啦，就喺加拿大同埋美國中間嗰個位置嘅。
And so in this slide, we just look at Nova Scotia itself, and we see the town marked where the sanctuary will be in Nova Scotia, and that's Port Hilford.
係啦，咁啱啱 Charles 咧就講到呢個地圖咧就係 show 俾大家睇 Nova Scotia 近啲嘅一個嘅位置嗰個概念啦。咁而家見到東面有一個有一個點個位咧，就係而家其實已經選擇咗成為海濱庇護所嘅一個位置嚟嘅。咁嗰個地方叫做 Port Hilford。
And so we looked at over 130 different sites in North America before selecting Port Hilford. And we selected it because it had all of the attributes that are necessary for a sanctuary. Depth and flow and good water space. But it also had a town that embraced everything about having a sanctuary.
咁啱啱 Charles 咧就講到，其實揀 Port Hilford 呢個位置之前咧，佢哋仲睇咗130個喺北美洲嘅位置，都係有機會成為海濱庇護所噶啦。咁但係點解最後會揀 Port Hilford 咧？就係佢哋已經係去過當即係唔同嘅位置去睇下唔同嘅水深啦，或者嗰度嘅水流啦，或者嗰度夠唔夠位置俾一啲放翻出去嘅圈養鯨豚去生活咧咁樣。咁另外一樣嘢就係佢哋都覺得呢一個小鎮 Port Hilford 嘅附近嘅市鎮咧係可以容納到呢一個海濱庇護所嘅。咁所以最後就選擇咗喺呢個位置度開展海濱庇護所嘅工作啦。
So here you see the actual sanctuary. This is 100 acres of water space, so much, much larger than anywhere a captive whale has ever been. It has depth, it has variety, it has all the kinds of enriching environment that these whales need to thrive. And that's why we've selected this site. And as you can see, there are no homes. So it is an environment that we can craft around the needs of the whales, and it's the needs of the whales that always come first.
咁啊 ，Charles 啱啱就講到呢張相咧，其實就係 Port Hilford 實際嗰個環境啦。咁佢你見到成個海灣嘅位置，大概係100英畝嘅水嘅位置水嘅空間啦。咁就比起任何圈養環境咧，比殺人鯨嘅圈養環境咧都大好多好多倍嘅。咁佢有足夠嘅水深啦，有足夠嘅環境嘅唔同嘅因素啦，好似好多一啲好豐富嘅因素，例如一啲水流啊，或者一啲自然環境嘅一啲俾到海豚鯨魚需要嘅一啲物質啊咁樣。咁大家亦都見到咧，呢個海灣其實附近咧係冇一啲建築物啦，冇民居啦咁樣，咁所以個環境咧，因為冇唔會影響到好多其他人啦，咁亦都係一個非常之理想去可以打造成為一個海濱庇護所嘅一個位置嚟嘅。咁我哋成立呢個海濱庇護所，最後都係即係想符合到所有呢啲殺人鯨或者鯨豚類動物需要嘅一啲條件啦。咁所以呢、這個點解佢哋覺得呢個位置係咁理想嘅一個原因嚟嘅。
That's actually the end of the slides on the sanctuary.
Okay, 咁啱啱係啦 ，Charles 就話呢個就係俾大家知道而家 Nova Scotia 個海濱庇護所嘅一啲最新嘅資料啦。咁亦都可以俾大家了解多啲究竟其實準備一個海濱庇護所需要做啲咩嘅咧，同埋大概海濱庇護所嗰個位置啊，或者之後個環境會係點樣嘅咧？咁我哋再問多 Charles 一條問題，就係其實即係大家見到 Charles 之前做咁多嘢啦，但係之後都即係好主力咁樣投入咗去推動呢個海濱庇護所工作啦。咁頭先開頭簡介 Charles 嘅時候都講過 ，Charles 係參與過一個虎鯨 Keiko 野放去翻冰島嘅一個工作嘅。咁而 Keiko 呢個故事咧，其實啟發咗好多我哋。就是現階段做緊去將圈養鯨豚放歸自然嘅工作啦。咁可唔可以請你分享多啲關於 Keiko 入邊呢個工作 嘅經驗點樣可以帶到我哋今日做呢個海濱庇護所嘅工作嘅階段咧？咁樣我知 Charles 又準備咗一啲 slide 去講下佢當年去點樣去野放 Kako 嘅經驗嘅，可以請 Charles 去分享一下。
So I was honored to be able to direct the Kako project, and this was more than 20 years ago.And Keiko was the whale that was a movie star, and a movie star in the Free Willy movie. So in that sense, he was chosen for returning to the wild because he was a movie star, not because he was necessarily the best candidate. More than 10,000 children wrote to Warner Brothers, the film people, and said,The whale is dying in Mexico City. You must return him to the wild. So Tyson, why don't you do that? And then we'll do more on the same slide.
Okay. 咁阿 Charles 咧啱啱就讲，其实佢自己都觉得好荣幸可以参与咗喺呢个 Kako 嘅计划入边啦。其实呢个计划已经系20年前嘅事嚟噶啦。咁 Kako 咧其实系一套电影 Free Willy 入边嘅主角啦。咁喺呢套電影之後咧，其實頭先 Charles 有講到咧，係有超過10,000個小朋友咧係寫咗信去呢個華納兄弟一個電影公司咧，就希望要求去將Kako 呢個殺人鯨咧係放翻去呢個自然一個海濱庇護所或者一個大海入邊嘅。咁就係、其實 Kako 頭先 Charles 講到咧，佢唔係一個未必係一個最好嘅一個殺人鯨。的個體去放回去大海入邊，但是因為當時因為呢個電影之後所產生的壓力咧，而令到整個社會係好似 force 咗佢，即係強硬要將呢條嘅殺人鯨去放回去大海咁樣嘅。因為大家覺得如果 Kako 繼續在佢喺墨西哥城入邊嗰個圈養環境入邊咧，佢會受很多苦啦，同埋都會好快就會死咗咁樣噶啦。I can continue.
And so what's very important about this and the reason the words are return to the wild rather than release, because for an orca to live in the wild, it needs to be with a family. It needs to be with a pod. So it's not just releasing Kako, it's helping Kako find a family that he can live with in the wild.
咁當時嘅計劃咧，除咗係話將 Kako 去放翻去自然環境之外咧，其實有一個再高層次啲嘅一個目標嘅，就係因為其實要將一個殺人鯨叫做完全回歸自然咧，佢係需要再重新去融入翻可能一個虎鯨嘅家族啦，咁樣先算係完全正常咁樣再喺野外嗰度生活啦。咁所以。當時係大家佢哋呢個團隊咧，係抱住呢個目標，就係希望將 Kako 去融入翻佢本身生活嗰個虎鯨嗰個族群入邊為一個目標嘅。
So before we moved Kako to Iceland, we moved him from the small tank in Mexico City where he was when the film was made to a special facility in Oregon for 2 years, where he gained 2,000 pounds in weight. He grew 7 inches in length, and he became healthy enough to then move to Iceland.
咁將 Kako 當時將 Kako 運去冰島之前咧，其實佢哋做咗一段時間嘅準備工作啦，包括就將 Kako 運咗去美國俄勒岡州嘅一個設施入邊啦，放咗喺嗰度2年啦，咁就做一連串嘅工作去將 Kako 準備放翻喺大海嘅。咁 Kako 當時係由墨西哥城嗰個好細嘅水缸入邊去咗俄勒岡州之後咧，其實佢增喺嗰個水池入邊係身大啲個水池入邊係增重咗2,000磅啦，亦都係長咗大概7寸咁樣啦。咁亦都係成個身體健康嘅狀況係已經改善咗好多，咁就再運。先再將佢運送去冰島嘅一個海濱庇護所咁樣。
So this is Kletsvik Bay in Iceland, and we netted off the bay and we put a bay pen inside. And the bay pen was where he lived in the beginning until he got comfortable with the whole area.
咁呢個就係、是、呢張圖就係 show 咗俾大家睇冰島當時做呢個海濱庇護所嘅海灣啦。咁大家見到呢個海灣咧，佢哋係用一個網去圍起咗嘅。咁、那個網入邊咧有一個細啲嘅一個叫 sea pen 啦，即係好似一個庇護，就係、是、庇護所嗰個位置啦。咁就當時係首先將 Keiko 放咗喺一個比較細嘅呢一個一個排入邊嘅。咁 Keiko 喺入邊。开始做适应啦，同埋慢慢去熟习个环境啦，咁之后先再将佢放翻去一个成个海湾大啲嘅呢个位置嘅。
And this is a beautiful day in Iceland, but in the winter we would have 120 knot winds, huge waves and ice in the bay。
咁呢张相大家见到个。個風景好靚啦，咁其實阿 Charles 啱啱就講到係一個天氣非常之好嘅日子嚟嘅，咁但係如果喺冬天咧，其實呢個位置都有機會會刮起好大嘅風啦，佢話有百幾海里嘅風啦，咁亦都冬天嘅時候係可能會有一層薄嘅冰會喺嗰個海灣嗰度形成咗嘅。
So the question is, how do you prepare a whale to return to the wild?And what you have to do is take the whale out for open ocean walks. So we would go out for 20, 30 miles of swim, getting Keiko prepared to swim with the wild whales. Basically like marathon training for a person. And this is a picture of going for a walk with Keiko.
咁其實要將一個虎鯨 Keiko 啦，要放翻去自然咧，係要一段時間去準備佢先可以即係真係去放佢出去嘅。咁其中一樣嘢就係佢要去建立佢嘅體能啦。咁就要佢哋當時就要帶 Keiko 咧，好似即係平時我哋帶狗仔出去行路咁樣，去同佢做運動咁樣。咁每次帶出去咧，就可能要去跟住個船遊20至30海里啦。咁就幫佢個身體去開始建立佢需要嘅體能啦，咁樣。咁呢張相咧就係話到俾大家聽，究竟係點樣去帶佢出去去行嘅咧？咁就係好似張相咁樣，佢就喺架船側邊，咁就架船一路陪住佢，咁就去行一段距離。
So here we're on an open ocean walk, and basically we would look for wild whales, and then.Keiko would approach the whales, and in some cases there was no interest by Keiko or the wild whales, and in other cases there was a lot of interest and they got close together. And we did this all summer for 4 years. So Keiko was out in the wild all the time for 4 years, and you could see how lively he was. He loved being out in the ocean.He was robust, that he took an interest in all of it, as well as in the whales.
咁喺帶佢出去行，即係帶佢出去運動嗰陣時候咧，其實佢哋都有另外一個目的啦，就係想睇下佢會唔會遇到其他啲野生嘅虎鯨咁樣嘅。咁當呢啲有啲野生嘅虎鯨去見到 Keiko 嘅時候咧，有啲就會唔理佢啦，咁有啲都會俾佢吸引咗埋嚟去睇下佢係點樣嘅。咁佢哋就做咗呢一個帶 Keiko 出去行嘅呢個工作咧，四個夏天做咗4年啦，咁樣。咁大家見到呢張相入邊咧，其實 Keiko 即係未必睇得好清楚啦，但係 Charles 就形容佢係非常之強壯啦，非常之健康啦。咁佢亦都係對周圍嘅環境咧，或者周圍其他嘅一啲虎鯨或者動物咧，都係非常之有興趣去 check out 佢哋，去即係睇下佢哋係咩嚟啊咁樣。
So here you see Keiko approaching other whales. And this is what we saw all the summer of the fourth year when he was basically staying with wild whales away from us, comfortable with them for weeks at a time.
咁呢張相咧，大家就見到有唔同嘅虎鯨喺入邊啦。咁就係阿 Charles 啱啱講係第四年咧，其實成個夏天咧。佢哋都見到 Keiko 係開始去冇咁近佢哋架船啦，就開始自己會走去同其他野外嘅虎鯨去一齊 去玩啦，去同佢哋接觸啦咁樣。咁佢哋都見到 Keiko 咧，其實佢當佢同其他野外嘅虎鯨去接觸嘅時候咧，都顯得越嚟越自在啦、舒適啦，即係佢開始已經習慣咗見其他嘅虎鯨啦咁樣。咁亦都可以開始同佢哋有啲互動啦。
So this is just to show you Keiko underwater away from our boat, and he would also come back to our boat on his own frequently.
咁呢張相，咁呢張相咧就見到其實 Keiko 咧就會，佢有時就會潛咗落水入邊啦，咁樣可能同其他三人鯨玩之後咧，咁就又會之後又會遊翻去佢哋個船邊嗰度。咁即係呢個狀態咧，就係佢哋帶佢出去行都維持咗一段時間咁樣嘅。
And in the summer of 2002, so in the fourth summer that we were there, he left us, Keiko left us and joined wild whales. He spent 3 weeks swimming with wild whales in Iceland, and then he swam 1,000 miles to Norway with wild whales when he left. But when he reached Iceland, when he reached Norway, excuse me, when he reached Norway, he was alone.
咁去到都系第四年嘅夏天啦，就2002年噶啦。咁 Keiko 咧就有一次就真系离开咗嗰、那个团队嘅船啦，咁就同咗一啲野外嘅虎鲸去一齐，咁就游咗3个礼拜啦。咁之后咧，佢就呢3个礼拜之后咧 ，Keiko 就继续跟住呢啲野外嘅虎鲸去咗第二个地方啦。咁之后团队咧就发现佢游咗超过1000嘅海里，就去咗挪威嗰度。咁但系去到挪威，当团队再发现翻 Keiko 嘅时候咧，佢已经得翻自己一个啦，就已经唔系再同其他虎鲸一齐啦。
So basically, when he reached Norway, he was not with wild whales, and he followed a fishing family, a fishing boat home up a fjord. And basically, he then lived the next year in the fjord, coming and going as he wanted. But we sent people to care for him. So they provided food, they provided anything he needed. But he was free to come and go as he wanted for the next year. And then he did die of a respiratory disease. He died of a lung disease in the winter of 2003. So he was in Norway for a full year before he passed away of the respiratory disease.
咁去到挪威嗰陣咧，因為頭先已經講過佢冇同其他野生嘅虎鯨一齊啦。咁但係團隊咧就發現佢經常都跟住一個漁民嘅家族一個家庭啦，去跟住啲漁船啦。咁當佢哋再發現佢嘅時候咧，咁就亦都派咗一隊嘅研究團隊嘅人員去啦，希望去睇住佢嘅狀況啦，亦都有喂佢食嘢啦。咁 Keiko 咧係好自由咁樣，佢可以嚟揾研究團隊嘅人啦，亦都可以自己去嗰個離開挪威嗰一個峽灣嗰度咧，去出去海嗰度自己咁樣生活嘅。咁 Keiko 喺大概呢一啲去到達挪威之後1年左右啦，咁就離開就死咗啦，離開咗我哋啦。咁佢係因為一個肺部嘅感染而離開嘅。咁但係咧，其實由佢去到挪威，去到佢死亡嘅呢段時間咧，已經係整整1年啦。咁所以佢都係有一個好自由嘅時間喺挪威，咁就好自由自在咁樣生活咗1年嘅。係啦，咁呢個就係非常之感謝 Charles 再分享咗呢個咁有趣嘅故事啦。咁大家如果有興趣又未睇過 Free Willy 呢個電影咧，我都非常之推介大家去睇下，究竟當時點解呢個電影咧會令到咁多人去關注咗呢個圈養虎鯨嘅呢個問題嘅。好啦，咁或者我都有一個小小嘅問題再 follow up 呢個分享啦，就係Charles 其實當時好多人咧喺 Keiko 死嗰陣認為，個計劃好似失敗咗嘅，因為佢去到就係你啱啱講到挪威之後1年，佢自由自在咁生活之後，但係1年就過咗身啦。咁會唔會你可以對呢啲人嘅睇法可以俾少少你嘅意見咧？咁同埋我想問下你喺 Keiko 身上面學到最重要嘅嘢又係咩咧？
So what we've learned is, first of all, that He was living in a wild environment for 5 years. He was also, at the time, the oldest male whale in captivity. And for the last 5 years of his life, he had the most enriching, robust life of any captive whale. So in that sense, it was a success for his quality of life for those 5 years.
咁 Charles 啱就講到咧，佢就認為雖然即係死咗就失敗咗啦，但係其實喺最後嗰五年咧，佢完全都係生活喺一個自然嘅環境入邊嘅。咁佢變得好健康啦，亦都即係好強壯啦。咁佢就覺得呢一個咁咁有質素嘅生活嘅一段時間咧，已經係一個非常之大嘅成功嚟噶啦。
So what did we learn?We've always known how easy it is to capture a whale. What we learned is how difficult it is to put one back. And that's why sanctuaries are so important.
咁啱啱 Charles 又講到，其實佢覺得呢個 Keiko 嘅計劃入邊最重要學到係咩咧？就係我哋成日都會可能會認為好容易就會喺野外捉到一條海豚翻嚟擺喺圈養環境啦。但係其實呢個計劃就表達咗俾大家聽，其實要放翻一條鯨豚動物出去係有幾咁難嘅喺野外環境出邊。咁所以大家就喺呢個 Keiko 入邊就可以學到就係究竟海濱庇護所有幾重要啦，因為佢就可以即係令更多嘅鯨豚可以容易啲去再適應野生環境咁樣。
Okay, just in many ways, it's not up to us to return a whale to the wild or to release it, because the whales have to find other whales to live with. So we have to remember that only two of the whales in captivity today do we know anything about their families. So the odds are we cannot find their families. So the most humane thing we can do is to create natural seaside sanctuaries where captive whales can thrive.
咁啱啱 Charles 就都講到，其實成個計劃另外一樣嘢令到大家明白嘅就係，其實要一個圈養嘅鯨豚再翻去野外環境生活咧，最難嘅一樣嘢就係將佢再融入翻一個家族入邊啦。咁佢提到咧，其實而家成個世界嘅圈養嘅鯨豚入邊咧，只係得兩條係真係知道佢係由邊一個家族嗰度嚟嘅啫，咁所以係一個非常之難去將佢哋去完全咁樣融入翻去野外環境噶啦。咁所以最終一樣嘢我哋可以做得最好，俾圈養鯨豚嘅提供到最高福利俾佢哋嘅一個措施咧，就係將佢哋放喺一個比較自然嘅海濱庇護所嗰度。咁已經係我哋大部分對大部分圈養鯨豚可以做到最好嘅一個俾佢哋嘅一個生活嘅環境啦。好啦，咁或者我哋同 Charles 傾偈嘅環節就去到呢度先，唔係去到呢度啦。咁就真係進入去回答公眾問題嗰一個環節啦。咁我哋啱啱見到有一個現場觀眾嘅提問，就係建立一個海濱庇護，佢問香港有冇條件可以做到一個海濱庇護所？咁或者我哋可以問，因為呢個問題 Charles 未必答到啦，因為佢始終唔喺香港啦。咁但係我哋可能可以問咗 Charles， 究竟個庇護所係需要有啲咩條件嘅咧？例如一啲環境嘅條件咁樣。咁我可能之後會再分享少少，究竟香港有冇呢啲條件去做一個海濱庇護所咧
？There are a number of physical requirements for a sanctuary. You need space, 60 or 100 acres of water space. You need a variety of depth, as much as 15 meters, 18 meters of depth, and shallow water. You need a lot of different environment on the bottom. So there's grasses and there's rocks and different things where the whales will be enriched. And you need a place where you're not interfering with fishing or homes or businesses. So you need an environment that's available for the sanctuary, and you need the people around it to embrace the idea and think it's a benefit for their community.
咁Charles 就認為咧，咁首先即係好簡單嘅一啲物理嘅因素啦，就係要夠大，要夠深啦。佢就話最少都可能要60至100個英畝啦。咁水深要有大概15至18米嘅，但係同時都有一啲潛水嘅位置，因為鯨豚生活係需要唔同一個環境嘅複雜性啦。咁要可能要有一啲好似天然嘅嘢啊，要有草啊，要有石頭啊咁樣。咁亦都嗰個環境係唔可以有太多嘅漁業啦，因為可能會影響到鯨豚啦。亦都其實個譬如好似頭先 Port Hilford 嘅海灣，最好係唔好有太多家居喺即係屋喺附近啦，唔好有咩商業嘅活動喺附近啦。咁亦都要成個海灣附近嘅所有人都去接受呢一個海濱庇護所係一個好嘅措施，唔會影響到一啲人類嘅生活咁樣嘅。咁或者關於香港嗰個問題，我就可以分享多少少啦。咁其實香港咧本身唔係一個非常之理想嘅地方去做一個海濱庇護所啦，因為其實香港大家都知，只有兩種係長期居住喺香港水域嘅鯨豚類動物啦，就係中華白海豚同埋江豚嘅。雖然我哋間中有時會有啲另外嘅品種，一啲比較離岸嘅品種會嚟到香港啦，但係始終對於嗰啲品種嚟講咧，都未必係一個好理想嘅生活環境嚟嘅。咁同埋香港都會經常被颱風去侵襲啦。其實每年夏天都會有某一定數量嘅颱風啦。咁所以如果起咗個海濱庇護所，大家見到頭先有個網啊，或者有個牌啊，咁樣都有機會咧會令到嗰個設施咧會損壞咁樣嘅。咁同埋所以香港咧，我哋如果一直講緊話將海洋公園嘅海豚去放到海濱庇護所咧，我哋係需要尋求一個可行嘅選址啦。可能喺其他國家，例如咧，其實有之前都有唔同嘅例子咧，係將一啲圈養嘅鯨豚由一個地方運到另一個。2019年咧，其實上海有兩條白鯨咧，就已經喺2019年嘅年中咧，係放咗喺冰島嘅一個海濱庇護所啦。咁佢哋而家都喺嗰度生活得好好嘅。咁而如果你講屏蔽海豚啦，咁 Rick O'Berry 嘅 Dolphin Project 咧，其實佢哋喺印尼嗰度咧已經都有一個成立咗運作緊嘅海濱庇護所噶啦。咁另外再一個例子就係、其實幾年之前咧，南韓嘅濟州島啦，佢哋因為法院嘅裁判啦，要佢哋嘅圈養嘅一啲公園咧，要放翻佢哋嘅屏蔽海豚出去大海啦。咁因為佢哋嘅屏蔽海豚係喺當地捉嘅，咁所以就佢哋就喺當地就設立咗一個海濱庇護所，咁就最後都將呢啲屏蔽海豚去放翻去大海嘅。咁所以我哋未來嘅工作咧，都可能要去到外國嗰度咧，去尋求有冇呢一啲可行嘅位置咁樣。好，咁或者去到第二條問題，又係交咗俾我哋嘅問題啦，就係、建立一個海濱庇護所咧，喺技術上會遇到啲咩困難咧？可以問一下，因為 Charles 對呢個喺呢個 Kiko 嘅計劃入邊非常之有經驗啦，咁就可以問多佢少少，究竟技術上會有啲咩嘅阻力咧咁樣。
So the challenges are first to find an ideal site. We looked for 2 years to find our site in Nova Scotia, and it is an ideal site because it has all the physical attributes and the human attributes to make it work. So the biggest challenge is finding a site. The second biggest challenge is certainly pulling together all the resources to do it. You have to raise a lot of money. And so this is a global effort. It's not about Canada or Hong Kong. It's about all of us doing this together around the world.
咁 Charles 啱啱就講到最大問題係咩咧？其實就係佢要首先揾到個選址，其實都已經非常之困難啦。咁揾加拿大東岸呢一個選址咧，其實佢哋花咗2年嘅時間去揾嘅。咁揾咗好耐，呢個選址點解咁理想咧？就是、因為所有一啲物理上嘅條件或者周圍嘅人嘅條件都符合佢哋想揾嘅地方啦。咁另外大家都會想像到就係、 呢個咁長時間嘅工作咧，其實係需要好多一啲資源啦，好多金錢啦咁樣。咁所以 Charles 啱啱就形容，其實海濱庇護所咧，唔係淨係一個國家需要去做嘅一個事情嚟嘅，而係全球要一齊去合作去做啦。唔係淨係香港或者唔係淨係加拿大去做嘅，因為我哋需要好多人去投入，可能去有資源嘅提供資源啦，有錢嘅提供錢啦，有知識嘅提供知識啦，咁樣一齊合作先可以。再容易啲去成立多啲海濱庇護所，去俾仲有好多生活緊喺圈養環境嘅鯨豚嘅。咁或者第三條其實有少少就係 follow up 頭先第二條問題嘅。咁要咁多錢嘅時候咧，其實好多營運緊嘅水族館咧，其實會好卻步啦，因為佢哋一來又唔想籌咁多錢，用咁多錢啦；二來又覺得即係哇，要好長時間先可以做到呢樣嘢喎。咁所以我哋根據 Charles 的經驗，其實是需不需要靠政府去立法去給壓力這些這場所，還是其實通常都可以由圈養的機構去自發去做這個海濱庇護所的可能初期的研究工作樣呢？
So I think the most important ingredient is public pressure. The public drives government and the public drives industry.Because if people vote with their feet by not going to public facilities, to marine parks, then the marine parks will work with people like us.
咁Charles 認為最重要嗰樣嘢咧，其實都係公眾壓力啦，因為佢認為公眾壓力會影響政府同埋成個業界嘅選擇啦。咁樣，如果我哋由呢一刻開始選擇，不去任何这些有圈养鲸豚或者圈养动物的水族馆或者主题公园，这些主题公园其实最后都会很迫于无奈，就要跟好像 Charles Whale Sanctuary Project 这些人合作，或者香港海豚保护会，我们去合作去寻求一个好一点的出路给这些动物的。好了，再下一条问题呢，就是其实可能 technical 一点，就是这个朋友呢就问，究竟有冇Charles 先唔知道有冇邊啲水族館嘅鯨豚係已經計劃咗會擺去海濱庇護所嘅咧？同埋呢一啲咁嘅工幾時會開始咧？咁樣係啊 ，yen 嘅問題嚟嘅。
So as a result of public pressure, the facility in France that holds four orca.Is now looking for a place to move the orca. We know in South Korea, because of public pressure, there are dolphinaria looking for new homes for their dolphins. So what we're seeing around the world is where the pressure of the public is moving government to pass laws to forbid keeping cetaceans in captivity.Then industry begins to follow suit. Industry follows. So our policy is to have open arms to the captive industry, to work with them to find a better life for their whales.
Charles 啱啱就提到咧，因为唔同嘅地方都有啲公众压力啦。咁尤其是喺法国咧，其实佢知道有一个设施。是有四条虎鲸的，咁已经开始揾紧地方去尝试将啲虎鲸放去海滨庇护所啦。而喺南韩咧，亦都有水族馆咧系尝试去揾紧一个新嘅屋企俾佢哋嘅圈养鲸豚嘅，咁都系海滨庇护所啦。咁样，咁所以佢认为即系佢都好强调，就系公众嘅压力真系非常之重要，因为公众压力会令到可能一啲立法嘅步骤会开始进行啦，咁就可能会。禁止咗圈養鯨豚啦，咁當呢啲圈養嘅產業要跟從呢啲法律嘅時候咧，咁我哋呢啲作為 NGO 咧就會去歡迎去呢啲圈養嘅產業咧，去同我哋合作咧，就揾一個方法去安置呢啲喺圈養入邊嘅鯨豚動物啦。係，唔好意思，啱啱嗰條咧就唔係阿 Yan 嘅問題嚟嘅，咁阿 Yan 咧。啱啱就喺現場就提咗一條問題啦，就係究竟個保護區咧係預計幾時可以正式使用咧？應該係問緊 加拿大嗰、那個、Nova Scotia 嗰個啦，同埋係咪已經有政府或者、一啲主題樂園承諾咗唔會再圈養同埋放翻去鯨豚去保護佢，定係 Charles 係要再去游說呢啲海洋嘅樂園嘅咧？即係究竟有冇一啲主題樂園入邊已經應承咗會將佢哋嘅鯨豚放去 Nova Scotia 嗰個海濱庇護所咧？咁樣？
We are having conversations with a number of different marine parks around the world. So we're not at liberty to say where we are in those discussions yet, but we're certainly having discussions to identify the first residents for our sanctuary.
Charles 啱啱就講到，其實佢哋嗰個工作咧已經即係不斷去咗唔同嘅一啲圈養嘅設施同佢哋溝通啦，咁但係因為即係都仲係溝通嘅階段入邊，咁就唔方便會同大家透露究竟係邊一個水族館嘅鯨豚將會放到去 Nova Scotia 嗰、那個 Port Hilford 個海濱庇護所啦，但係佢哋一直都會繼續著呢個溝通嘅工作，咁好快就會去可以揾到一啲適合放去 Port Hilford 嘅圈養鯨豚嘅啦。咁或者我哋再去下一條問題啦，都仲有好多問題啊，仲有幾條問題我哋可以再問埋嘅。咁比起爭取海豚退役嘅福利咧，即係成立海濱庇護所啦，咁我哋都係想將已經喺圈養入邊嘅鯨豚嘅福利提升啦。但係呢位朋友咧就問，點解唔直接去提倡禁止鯨豚圈養咧？咁樣，例如好多國家都已經禁止咗海豚表演啊，或者禁止佢哋繁殖等等。咁呢兩個工作邊一個係 Charles 覺得會嚟得比較重要咧
？I think there has to be a place for the dolphins in captivity to go if there's legislation banning keeping them in captivity. So it's not one or the other; it's both.We have to do it all, and we can do it all together. And that's why a conversation like this with me in California and Tyson in Hong Kong is so important, because we can all work together to have legislation and to create sanctuaries, which is the solution for captivity.
咁 Charles 就認為咧，其實海濱庇護所啦，同埋立法呢兩個工作咧，係即係缺一不可啊。其實兩邊都要同時進行嘅，因為如果你想象下，立咗法禁止咗海豚圈養、鯨豚圈養，咁啲動物去邊咧？咁我哋都需要有一個海濱庇護所嘅。咁所以我哋倡議緊海濱庇護所，同時都要同時去做呢個遊說立法嘅工作啦。咁就建立一啲海濱庇護所俾鯨豚啦，咁佢亦都覺得就係點解咁我哋譬如我哋今日嘅對話咁重要，香港同加拿大嘅都嘅NGO 都去溝通咧，就係因為我哋需要多啲人去投入呢個工作，而令到更加多嘅海濱庇護所係可以成立嘅。咁或者去到再下一條就係Charles 覺得公眾嘅參與點樣可以幫到呢個海濱庇護所成立咧？又或者即係公眾參與點樣可以幫助到呢個鯨豚保育咧？咁樣。
Well, I think the public, by sharing conversations and by sharing them with more and more people, they can influence a worldwide.Program, a worldwide mission to move whales and dolphins out of captivity and into sanctuaries. And yes, they're expensive, but they're less expensive than any new tank in a captive facility. So together, we can all raise the money to do what's right for the whales.
咁 Charles 就啱啱形容到咧，公眾要做一樣嘢就非常之重要，就係將我哋譬如今日嘅對話，或者你學到關於圈養鯨豚嘅問題啊，去同身邊嘅朋友去講啦，咁樣。咁因為呢啲咁嘅對話，咁樣呢啲教育嘅工作咧，其實會影響到成個世界嘅一啲 例如 Whale Sanctuary Project 啊，或者我哋香港海豚保學會嘅一啲工作啦，咁樣咁亦都係加速咗去將圈養鯨豚咧，係同埋放翻去嘅海濱庇護所嘅工作去運作得更加順暢嘅咁樣。咁海濱庇護所要成立當然係非常之貴啦，頭先都講過，但係其實阿 Charles 啱啱就形容，其實呢一個工作咧唔會比去建立一個新嘅水族館係更加貴嘅。咁所以我哋一齊都要大家所有公眾包括同埋我哋 NGO 都一齊努力咁樣去令到更加多嘅圈養鯨豚咧係有可能去運到海濱庇護所。咁我哋再問多一題啊，因為都仲有好多問題啊，我哋嘗試去盡量高呼更加多朋友嘅問題。咁啱啱見到呢個朋友咧，就問其實香港政府咧都好受動物權益嘅團體嘅意見啦。咁嘉賓就係可能 Charles 或者我咁樣會建議我哋香港市民除咗教育可以做啲咩咧？咁頭先講咗話要教育身邊嘅人啦，但係除咗教育，我哋仲可以做啲乜嘢咧？咁如果海洋公園去最近大家都知道，咁啊佢哋嘅財政嘅困難而要轉型啦，可能變咗個商場啊咁樣。咁我哋如果喺呢個情況之下，又可以點樣去保障翻動物嘅福利咧？咁或者 Charles 可以簡單講下，例如除咗教育之外，啱啱講過你覺得好重要嘅。咁除咗教育之外，咁公眾仲可以有啲咩工作可以做到咧？咁樣。
Well, I think the public in Hong Kong can continue to advocate for better conditions for dolphins that are in dolphin area. And they can educate their children so that their children believe that whales and dolphins have to be in nature and not in captivity. And that will put pressure on the dolphin area and the government to make change. But we have to be ready for the change as well. So we all have to work together to bring about a better life for the dolphins. And I think the business model for the dolphin area can change because we have modern technology, we have VR, we have AI, we have all the technology to show people in a theater, in a dolphin area, the dolphins that are now in a sanctuary. And we can teach children about how they live in nature, from nature, rather than from a dolphin area.
咁啊 ，Charles 啱啱都再強調，其實始終教育都係最重要啦，尤其是我哋下一代，我哋一定要令到佢哋明白，海豚或者其他鯨豚動物係根本唔屬於圈養環境嘅，而係應該係喺大自然入邊生活嘅咁樣。咁呢樣嘢佢就再強調，都係可以俾到壓力一啲圈養嘅設施啦，或者政府啦。但係同時，我哋即係 NGO 都要做好一個準備嘅工作，就係當呢啲成個社會嘅風氣轉變嘅時候，我哋要有海濱庇護所去 ready 俾呢啲圈養嘅鯨豚去擺入去，等佢哋有好啲嘅生活嘅。咁 Charles 啱啱都提到另一樣嘢好重要嘅就係、是。其實而家已經有好多唔同嘅高科技啦，好似AI 啊或者 VR 啊一啲虛擬影像咁樣去 show 到俾公眾或者小朋友睇，究竟一個海豚或者鯨魚一個動物係點樣啦？大家可以坐喺個影院入邊就已經見到，而唔需要去呢啲海洋嘅主題樂園嘅。咁所以我哋最重要都係要教識我哋嘅下一代，海豚係屬於大自然啦。而我哋都已經有好多方法去學習關於佢哋嘅知識啦，而已經唔需要再去水族館去學習關於鯨豚嘅保育嘅資訊嘅。係啦，咁我哋見到Facebook Live 都仲有幾條問題，或者我哋問多兩條啦，因為時間都差唔多啦，但係我哋都想答到多啲大家嘅問題。或者問呢條啊，呢條都好有趣，係咪每一條鯨豚都適合放喺海濱庇護所嘅咧？根據 Charles 嘅經驗，如果唔係每一條鯨豚都適合放去海濱庇護所或者回歸大自然咧，我哋點知道邊一個比較合適用 technical 嘅方法去處理咧？即係可能佢嘅問題就係、是，究竟我哋點樣先知道邊一啲鯨豚係會適合放去海濱庇護所啊？甚至係會唔會有啲鯨豚係適合去真係去野放，好似 Kiko 咁樣做嘅咧？係我哋係要啲咩條件先可以話到俾即係我哋點樣去評估邊一條鯨豚去適合去野放咧咁樣
？So all species are candidates for going into a sanctuary.So it's not about choosing a species, but it is about understanding the health of each individual dolphin or whale that would be considered. So they need to be in reasonable health. They need not to have any kind of pathogen that could infect wild animals, because we don't want to do anything to harm wild whales as well.So there's a protocol for selecting the whales and dolphins before they go to a sanctuary. And there's months of preparation at the marine park with the people who have been caring for them before. So all species are possible, but we have to look at each individual on their own before moving them and selecting them for life in a sanctuary.
咁 Charles 咧就認為其實我哋揀邊一個鯨豚去適合放翻去海濱庇護所咧，就唔係根據佢嗰個品種或者物種嘅。咁最重要就係我哋要睇翻每一個海豚或者鯨豚個體嘅健康狀況啦，同埋佢會唔會有身體會有一啲唔好嘅細菌啊，或者一啲疾病係有機會去傳染咗去一啲野外嘅鯨豚身上啦。因為我哋其實做呢個工作。除了去提升圈養鯨豚的福利之外，另外一件事很重要，我們都不想影響到野外的環境或者野生的動物。這樣這些準備圈養鯨豚放歸海濱庇護所的工作是要經過好幾個月的準備，要訓練員或者平時去照顧這些鯨豚的人員去一起 去準備這些工作，訓練他們。咁當佢哋適合可以再放翻去呢個海濱庇護所，或者甚至去放歸自然之前咧，其實有好多工作去準備。咁就成個過程咧，係有一個步驟去跟從啦。佢哋已經 develop 咗一個，即係發展咗一個係好似一個守則咁樣去跟啊，即係每一步點樣去訓練咧，點樣去評估每一個狀態適唔適合。最後佢哋適唔適合去放翻去海濱庇護所咧？咁樣咁，但係佢都再強調一個問題，再強調一個重點就係、其實所有物種、所有品種都係可以係放翻去海濱庇護所嘅一個對象嚟嘅。咁但係最重要係睇翻個體嗰個情況。咁我哋或者時間都差唔多啦，我哋去埋我哋問多一條公眾嘅問題。就係、是我哋 Charles 或者我啦，覺得圈養嘅鯨魚或者海豚，你會喺中國內地嘅圈養業啦，我哋有咩睇法咧？咁樣係咪比起香港或者即係如果 specifically 即係獨立咁樣，即係專門咁樣睇，就係香港海洋公園啦，究竟係咪中國內地嗰個情況會比香港嗰個情況更加差咧？我不知道 Charles 有沒有去過內地的場館，但我想 Charles 有看過很多片段，可能是關於一些亞洲或者大陸的一些圈養場所的，或者可能 Charles 可以簡單看看他會不會有什麼 comment 給這條問題，之後我也可以再補充多一點。
Situation in China is very serious because they're building more marine parks.Than anywhere else in the world. And therefore, they're a market, an import market for captive whales and dolphins. What I'm pleased to say is that there are organizations like yours in China that are advocating for change. And we need to continue to reach out to China, to reach out to the children in China, and show them that there's a better way. So they'll put pressure on the Chinese government and the Chinese marine parks, just the way you're putting pressure in Hong Kong. We need to do it everywhere. The situation in China is difficult, but we need to be persistent, as Tyson has said, and we need to continue to do our good work everywhere.
咁 Charles 就提到啦，即係以佢所認識嘅，即係喺中國內地嘅圈養產業咧，佢覺得係即係已經非常之嚴重啦嗰個問題，因為已好多嘅場館已經起緊或者起緊起咗好多啦已經，咁所以有一個好大嘅市場去令到其他地方要捉一啲野外嘅鯨豚或者海豚嘅動物去到呢啲咁嘅場館咁樣。咁所以佢都即係佢又再一次即係讚賞我哋嘅機構啦，就是、我哋做咗好多工作去俾壓力政府或者俾壓力海洋公園咁樣。咁佢認為同時即係、就是、同時間咧，其實中國大陸都需要有呢啲咁嘅團體咧去做呢啲咁嘅壓力俾壓力嘅工作啦，或者游說嘅工作啦，去令到更加多嘅市民喺香港又好喺中國又好可以明白多啲究竟圈養。嘅圈養嘅海豚嘅問題有幾嚴重咧？咁樣咁係佢認為內中國大陸嘅情況係好難噶，但係即係要一定要持久啦呢個工作，因為始終教育係需要時間啦咁樣。咁或者我再 comment 多少少就係、是、我自己親身都有去過一啲內地嘅水族館嘅。咁如果同香港海洋公園比起上嚟咧，咁香港嘅海洋公園的而且確係比內地水族館的質素是比較高啦，包括我們的獸醫的質素高一點啦，內地可能有些水族館連獸醫都沒有的，那場地的、那個質素也都比較好啦，保養得比較好一點啦。我們看到有些很新的內地的一些水族館呢，其實它可能起了半年，但是那個折舊的情況已經非常嚴重，就是因為它們可能用的建築的物料啊，或者他們本身的設計都是比較差的，所以令到大家都可能在新聞上面聽過很多，就是哪裡中國哪個城市又有一隻最慘的北極熊啊，或者有一些很慘的、即海豚啊，或者海牛啊在裡面，那個情況是即很都挺難想像的，如果你沒有親身去過。所以我們最重要的一件事就是我們經常都罵香港海洋公園啦，但是譬如大家都不要、去忽視了，譬如你去旅遊去外地玩的時候，去到譬如日本看到、水族館是一個很著名的景點，但是千萬都不要支持這些水族館，因為其實好像 Charles 首先開頭都有說，整個 反對圈養鯨豚或者海濱庇護所這個工作是一個全球性的一個需要大家合作的一個工作來的，所以大家要記住經常要去教育身邊的人，經常要 update 自己多些資訊，要持久，因為這些遊說、啊、這些跟身邊的人分享資訊的工作是需時的，但是我們是轉變的了、就是、包括其實海洋公園都在近這十年呢根據過很多次不同的公眾的壓力而改變過他們的決策啦，例如2011年、2012年他們都因為本身是想購入白鯨的，都因為公眾的壓力而最後沒有購入啦，那這些這麼小的勝利呢，是雖然、未必是做到一個很大的轉變啦，但我們都要去、就是、鼓勵自己，其實我們不斷去自己去學習多些知識，或者去教育身邊的朋友，再同時給一些壓力我們的政府和我們的產業呢，其實都會最後會帶來一些很實質的轉變的。咁或者我哋今日嘅活動就去到呢度啦，都已經超過咗一個小時啦。咁非常之多謝 Charles 今日出席我哋嘅活動啦。或者我想再問多次 ，Charles 會唔會可能有一個結語或者一個 conclusion 想俾翻我哋今日嘅觀眾咧
？Well, first I want to thank all of you for joining with Tyson and me today. It's an honor for me to meet Tyson and to meet all of you virtually.But I think the most important takeaway from today is that there is hope for the whales that are in captivity. It's possible to create sanctuaries for them throughout the world. And we can do this only if we're all working together and if we're communicating with one another about the problems we face and the solutions that we can bring together. And so that's really, to me, what's most important is working with you, having you know that you can work with us, and that we're all in this together, and that we're going to solve the problem and create sanctuaries for the dolphins and whales that are in captivity. It's been done for elephants. It's been done for chimpanzees. It's been done for the big cats. Now's the time for all of us together to do it for cetaceans, for whales and dolphins.
咁 Charles 最後多謝我哋邀請佢出席今日嘅活動啦。 咁 雖然我哋唔係親身一齊，但係我哋都係喺一個合作嘅形式咁樣就順利咁樣去進行咗今日呢個座談會嘅。 咁 佢有一點想大家喺今日嘅活動之後係記住嘅，就係我哋將圈養鯨豚放翻去。 海濱庇護所咧係非常之有希望嘅，因為其實已經做過啦，同埋已經做緊噶啦。咁所以我哋要即係最重要嘅就係要 keep 住一齊繼續溝通啦，好似我哋唔同即係國際嘅組織去合作啦，去一齊去展開新嘅工作啦咁樣。咁佢亦都形容到其實一啲庇護所咧已經喺陸地上面有做，我哋有做過俾。 大笨象啦，大象啦，有一啲大型嘅貓科動物啦，或者一啲大猩猩啦咁樣。咁而家其實就係一個時間咧，我哋去將呢個工作去推展到呢個海豚鯨豚動物身上，令到呢啲可能曾經喺圈養環境生活嘅動物咧有更好嘅生活咁樣。係啦，咁我哋都要再一次多謝 Charles 今日去花咗一個鐘同我哋傾偈啦。咁呢個。 而家已經係黃昏嘅時間啦，咁 Charles 抽空出席咗今日嘅活動係非常之難得嘅。咁我亦都好希望真係之後個疫情嘅情況好轉之後咧，我哋唔知會唔會真係有機會去邀請 Charles 嚟到可能香港啊，或者我哋親身去同 Charles 可以講更多關於海濱庇護所啊，或者鯨豚圈養嘅問題啦。咁而家呢個階段咧，我只可以同大家講就係我哋。 可以繼續留意多啲海濱庇護所嘅新聞啦，因為我知道 Charles 喺加拿大嗰邊已經越嚟越多工作進行緊，已經即將可能都會有鯨豚放到去嗰個海濱庇護所噶啦。咁我哋就期待更加多嘅好嘅消息，喺不久將來會有更加多嘅鯨豚可以擺到海濱庇護所啦。咁我哋今日亦都喺 Charles 身上學咗好多嘢啦。咁我希望在場嘅觀眾問咗問題嘅觀眾。 又好，或者之後其實大家可以將呢個 Facebook Live 去 share 出去啦，俾身邊嘅朋友啦。我哋呢個短片會擺喺 Facebook 一段時間嘅，咁大家可以就係隨意咁樣去 share 俾身邊嘅朋友啦。覺得有趣嘅，亦都可以聽完之後未必 share 俾身邊嘅朋友，即係直接 share 個 link 俾朋友，但係都可以將你今日聽到或者學到嘅資訊再同翻屋企人啊或者朋友講咁樣。咁最重要就係即係大家喺呢個疫情之下去。 保持自己身體健康啦，同埋去 take care 咁樣嘅，咁或者我簡單用英文講一次，就係同 Charles 講多謝啦咁樣。So thank you so much for Charles for spending your evening with us today. So I sincerely hope that we can have you maybe in person to have another conversation in Hong Kong or in the States to talk more about Whale Sanctuary Project. And in the meantime, I'll wait for more good news related to the seaside sanctuary in the coming future. I hope there will be a lot of good news from you. And I've learned so much from you, Charles, today. And I hope everyone of our audience feels the same. And I just want to say thank you again, Charles.
Thank you very much, yep. Tyson. And it's an honor for me to be with you. Thank you.
Thank you so much. So I hope everyone will enjoy the rest of your weekend and take care and stay safe. See you again.